इट्स मी डॉक्टर प्रसाद पुदेलम विद अ न्यू क्लास सीरीज ऑन थर्मल एनालिसिस और थर्मल मेथड्स। दिस पर्टिकुलर क्लास वीडियो इज फॉर थर्मोग्रामेट्रिक एनालिसिस। थर्मल एनालिसिस मेथड्स इट्स अ ब्रांच ऑफ मटेरियल साइंस वेयर द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटेरियल्स आर स्टडीड एज दे चेंज विथ टेम्परेचर। देर आर सेवरल मेथड्स यूज कॉमनली विच आर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड फ्रॉम ईच अदर बाई द प्रॉपर्टी विच इज मेजर्ड। Three of the important thermal analysis methods are TGA, DTA, and DSE. And this particular class video is for TGA, which measures the change in mass. TGA, or thermal gravimetric analysis, or even thermogravimetric analysis, is a method of thermal analysis in which changes in physical and chemical properties of materials are measured as a function of increasing temperature or as a function of time. The various mass changes that can occur in by increasing the temperature of the sample may be due to desorption, absorption, sublimation, vaporization, oxidation, reduction, and even decomposition. Therefore, TGA analysis can be used for volatile products, can be used for thermoplastic, thermoset, elastomers, composites, thin films, fibers, coating, as well as for paints. There are three different types of TGA. Among two of them are mentioned here, that is isothermal or static TGA. In this case, the sample is maintained at a constant temperature for a period of time during which change in weight is recorded. And in dynamic TGA, the sample is subjected to conditions of continuous increase in temperature at a constant heating rate. The instrumentation of TGA. The instrument setup we call it as thermobalance, and the thermobalance consists of a microbalance, a furnace, a sample holder, a temperature programmer, a temperature controller, and a recording system. The first one, that is the recording balance or electronic balance, mainly microbalance is used to record the change in mass. The sample is kept in the microbalance and it is left for 10 to 15 minutes to stabilize. There are so many features that is required for an ideal balance. It should accurately and reproducibly record the change in mass of the sample in wide ranges of atmospheric conditions and temperatures. And it should provide electronic signal to record the changes in mass. And the signal provided should be a rapid response to change in mass. It should be stable at a high temperature, that is both mechanically as well as electrically it should be stable at high temperature, and it should be user friendly. The second one, that is furnace. A furnace should be designed appropriately so that linear heating rate can be achieved. And the furnace, it creates a hot zone. The hot zone includes the sample holder and the sample. And uniform temperature should be distributed to the sample holder as well as the sample. And also the atmospheric condition present should be different. Therefore, the material which is used to make the furnace should be stable at a high temperature regime. There are many various type of materials used to increase the temperature. We call it as heating coils. The heating coils, it may be platinum, which it can be used when the temperature requirement is below 1300 degrees Celsius. Then we can use nichrome wire, silicon carbide, rhodium, graphite, or tungsten is used. Tungsten is used when the temperature conditions are required above 2400 degrees Celsius. As well as the furnace should, the heating coil used, it should not create any magnetic field there. If a magnetic field is created, it will affect the change in mass of the sample. Even the size of the furnace also plays an important role. If the furnace is having high mass, that means it will ensure uniform hot zone, but it takes more time to reach the temperature conditions. Whereas if you use low weight furnaces, quick heating happens, and there will be difficulty in controlling the rate of increase in temperature. The position of furnace also affect the quality of analysis. The given image represents the spring type balance which is used. It is in which the furnace is placed below the weighing balance. We call it as a quartz spring type balance. or even the beam type balance also used, in which the weighing balance is placed above in different positions to the furnace position. Temperature controller, thermocouple is mainly used to measure the temperature, then the controlling takes place. Similar to the heating coil, various type of materials are used for fabrication of thermocouple, which include tungsten or platinum alloys. Platinum alloys, namely the chromel or alumel, are used as thermocouple for measuring temperature conditions below 1100 degrees Celsius. And if the temperature conditions required is above 1100 degrees Celsius, tungsten material is used. Even the position of the thermocouple also plays an important role. If it is placed near to the crucible with no contact among thermocouple and sample container, this type of setup is not usually preferred under low pressure conditions. The thermocouple can be positioned below the sample container and in contact with the sample holder, but it will respond to the only small changes in temperature conditions. In the third method, in which a thermocouple is placed inside the sample container, so that it will record the temperature changes immediately, and this type of arrangement is widely preferred and generally employed for accurate measurements. Fourth one, that is temperature programmer. The programmer is basically used to control the heating rate even when the temperature goes or increases during the analysis. A heating rate is customized to be recorded in degree per minute in terms of Kelvin or Celsius scale. The rate of heating or cooling can be considered as constant when the temperature versus time curve appears to be linear. Fifth one, that is the recording system or data recording unit. It is basically maybe a chart recorder or even microcomputer, but nowadays we go for microcomputer because it has got more benefits. It enables the provision to both save and plot the temperature versus weight loss curve using pre-installed software, and that facility is not there in chart recorder. And also microcomputer helps in plotting the multiple weight loss curves in simultaneous manner. Sixth one, that is sample holder. A sample holder is nothing but is a crucible. The sample to be subjected for investigation or characterization, it is placed in the crucible, which is attached to the weighing arm of the balance. There are different shapes and size, and even materials are used for crucible. Some of the shapes are represented here in the image. The main material employed for making crucible include aluminium, platinum, and quartz, and even stainless steel, glass, and graphite is also used as a sample holder. The crucible should be having at least 100 degrees Celsius higher thermal stability as compared to the experimental temperature conditions. The crucible is selected should be efficient and uniform, uniformly should transfer heat to the sample. In case of powdered sample, generally flat crucibles are used, and for liquid type samples, we go for walled crucibles. TGA thermograms or even TGA curves. The plot of mass change in percentage versus temperature or time is called a thermogram, or also known as TGA curves, and that is the typical result of a TGA analysis. The different weight gains or weight losses which happens during the TGA analysis, the weight loss may be due to decomposition or maybe due to evaporation or reduction or even desorption, whereas the weight gain, the sample will gain weight when it undergoes oxidation with the atmosphere present, or even it absorb or adsorb some molecules. The interpretation of a TGA curves or the factors which influence the shape of thermogram, typically seven different thermograms are observed, which are represented here. The curve one, which shows no change in mass on increasing the temperature, that means the sample is stable at those temperatures. The curve two represents the desorption or drying, that if the interaction atmosphere, if it is non-interacting atmosphere, then this curve two will be similar to that of curve one. The third one, the curve three, it shows the single step decomposition. curve 4 represents a multi-stage decomposition, and curve 5, it is similar to curve 4, but here it is maybe due to the fast heating rate or due to the formation of no intermediate. Atmospheric reactions is given by the curve 6, so that means it undergoes oxidation reaction mainly. And even curve 7, it is similar to that of a curve 6, so oxidation takes place, but it is followed by decomposition, so that weight further it loses. The information or applications of thermogravimetric analysis, it can be used for thermal stability studies, because these thermal stability studies are important in case of engineers who construct materials or application in high temperature conditions, which alloy or which polymer can, or even which nanomaterial can be used, that can be analyzed by TGA. Even some of the compositions of sample can be analyzed by using TGA. Say example, in case of filler content in polymers, or carbon black in oils, ash and carbon in coal, moisture content of many substances can be analyzed by using TGA. Another important application, that is to identify the procedure decomposition temperature. It is the temperature in degree Celsius or Kelvin at which a cumulative change in mass attain a magnitude, so that it can be detected by the thermobalance. So here in the given thermogram, the position B indicates the procedure decomposition temperature. Even TGA can be used for material characterization, that is for identification and quality control. Some say that you can use it as a fingerprinting, but it cannot be used as a fingerprinting as such, because same materials thermogram will vary with a different thermobalance that we use. It can be used for kinetic studies. Even it can be used for corrosion studies, because corrosion, where the surface phenomena, the oxidation of the metal takes place, so it may gain mass or lose weight. So for corrosion studies can also be done with TGA. Some of the example for TGA curves, example silver nitrate, the decomposition of silver nitrate at high temperature. Silver nitrate decomposition reaction is given here. Silver nitrate AgNO3 gives Ag plus NO2 plus half O2. And this reaction starts at around 473 degrees Celsius. The horizontal portions A, B as well as C, D here represents the region where there is no change in mass on increasing temperature, whereas the BC, region BC represents the procedure decomposition temperature of AgNO3, that is 473 degrees Celsius, and it continues till 608 degrees Celsius, and it indicates the loss of NO2 as well as oxygen gas. So the AB region indicates that silver nitrate is thermally stable up to 473 degrees Celsius, and the region CD represents the thermal stability of metallic silver. Another example, that is cupric nitrate hemipentahydrate, CuNO3 twice 2.5 H2O. The different possible reactions on increasing temperature is given here. CuNO3 twice 2.5 H2O, initially it loses the water of hydration at around 100 to 150 degrees Celsius and becomes CuNO3 twice. Then further, CuNO3 twice will be converted into CuO, cupric oxide, with the removal of NO2 as well as 3/2 O2. It happens around 200 to 280 degrees Celsius. So the region BC indicate the loss of water of hydration. The region DE indicate loss of NO2 as well as oxygen gas. And cupric oxide, CuO, it is thermally stable up to 950 degrees Celsius. Another example, that is of that of copper sulfate pentahydrate. Copper sulfate pentahydrate, initially it loses 2 moles of water of hydration at around 100 degrees Celsius. Then further, the copper sulfate trihydrate loses 2 more water of molecule to become copper sulfate monohydrate. And copper sulfate monohydrate at around 300 degrees Celsius loses the water of molecule to become anhydrous copper sulfate. Another example, that is thermal decomposition of calcium oxalate monohydrate, CaC2O4.H2O. At around 200 degrees Celsius, it loses the water of hydration Then at around 500 degrees Celsius, it loses carbon monoxide to become calcium carbonate. Then at around 800 degrees Celsius, the calcium carbonate further decomposes to give calcium oxide with the removal of carbon dioxide as gas. So this is about the different examples. And here this particular example, the red line indicates the TG curve and the blue line, it represents the derivative of the TG curve, derivative, or we call it as derivative thermogram. So the derivative thermogram, it gives sharp peaks. So it is easy to identify the exact temperature at which the decomposition or the weight loss or weight gain that going to happen. So that's about the thermogrammetric analysis. Hope you understood this video class. Thank you very much for watching this video and have a nice day.